It's a great pleasure to have Yazdi Tantra with us this morning. I mean, he's the person who is responsible for getting the community together. He's a glue which combines the international community. But Yazdi Tantra is by profession a chartered accountant, but he's also many other things. He's a computer consultant, he's an entrepreneur developer by hobby, and a trainer in his leisure time. He has also been very active in promoting several Zoroastrian websites in the firm belief that this modern media, and we all know about this media, will help unite our far-flung diasporic community across the globe. Zoroastrian.net, which is his website, brings as many Zoroastrian resources as possible all under one roof. And this website has received a million hits in 7 years, including from the Vatican City and from PhD students outside India. 10,000 viewers per day, and that's not a small feat, through multiple related channels. It is a reliable getaway to valuable online Z resources. And apart from the Zoroastrian study sites which he runs, he also runs the following blogs: www.consumerresources.india, I'm sure Yazdi will tell us about it, and www.enterprises.in. And he also, in addition to all this, as he doesn't have enough time in the day, writes a regular column in the Parsi Times Mumbai on Android devices for productivity at the workplace. I read his columns. He's currently the vice chairman and chairman of the IT committee at the Zoroastrian Cooperative Bank. He runs a medium-sized computer company online for at least 24 years, developing websites, portals, payment gateways, sales and services of computer hardware. And he's the ex-director of the tech and the technical chair of the World Zarathustra Chamber of Commerce. And if you've seen their websites, it's something to look at. He's also associated with the Patak Educational Trust, which caters to more than 42,000 students from kindergarten to senior college with vocational courses thrown in. And his latest project is to develop the genealogy of Parsi lineage, and he's about to tell us about it, which is a very interesting concept to know our history and our traditions and how we came from and where we came from, and I think we should all contribute towards that website. So without much ado, I give you Yazdi, which is a great pleasure because he's a good friend of mine.
Thank you, Dolly. And I must thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity at the last moment to present a few of our websites. The basic purpose of this is connecting the community. That is what the basic underlying theme of this entire project is. So we start with the need to connect and how we do it. The need to connect, as we all know, is a psychological need. We are all social animals. In fact, this very conference is arising out of the need to connect. Because if we don't have these sort of meets, we are not meeting. And if we don't meet, we get all worked up. We all know that. What is the worst form of punishment you can give to a criminal?
Solitary confinement.
Because if you don't allow the person to connect, then it's really bad. And therefore, we talk about so psychological need, which is giving happiness in the long run. That is what this is all about. And how we do it is through our various websites. That is what the entire talk is about. We start with a very basic website, which is a resource-driven website for the community. It is called Zoroastrians.net. The idea for Zoroastrians.net started in a very small discussion where we were talking about resources not being available to the community, especially to the youngsters. And we should have some gateway to resources across the globe. So we have so many websites on Zoroastrians and Zoroastrianism, and they are all scattered all over the place. There are news websites, there are books, there are songs, there are stories, so on and so forth. So what we thought is we should have a central repository, which will be the gateway to all the resources online. And that is how the idea of Zoroastrians.net was born. So what do we have on this Zoroastrians.net? We have information on books, businessmen, professionals, matrimonials. As far as books are concerned, we have a whole lot of books which we have digitized. A lot of people have been kind enough to part with their copyrights and give us that information. We have a very famous book by Dr. Jeevanji Modi on the Zoroastrian way of life. Then we have books by Khojastimistry, which is on catechism of Zoroastrianism. Most of it was not available online. Many books, Parsis of Nausari, many books in audio form, they are all available online. Books by Parsi authors may not be related to religion, but books by Parsi authors are also available online. So you could go to the books section and go through any number of books that you may have on the community, by the community. Matrimonials is, of course, very famous because everybody is looking for a matrimonial site, and there are so many websites which are available. There are so many resources which are available for matrimony online. So if you go to the matrimonial section, you'll see a list of websites or even individuals who are doing this matchmaking business, either online or offline. So that is one very popular area. Calendars, I don't know if you know, if you're aware that there are lots of Zoroastrian calendars which are available online as apps as well as online, where you can print them out and keep them in your own office or home. Scholarships and grants, this is a very useful place. In our education section, we have scholarships from across the world. Typically what happens is this information is available only in certain pockets. Like India scholarships are only available for people in India. US scholarships are only available for people in US. UK scholarships are available for people in the UK. But when a person is wanting to travel from one place to the other, they need to understand what all scholarships are available in that particular country. And we have a whole list of both Zoroastrian and non-Zoroastrian scholarships. Scholarships for minorities, scholarships for specific training, like education for medical, professional education, management education. There are certain scholarships which are very specific. All those are available in one place. In fact, if you have somebody who needs to have any scholarship, if you go to the education section on our website, you'll be able to see all the scholarships listed. And it is fairly detailed. Like, you may have about 1,000 scholarships available. And they are updated every time a new scholarship comes up. Food, of course, is one of the favorites. You have various recipes. And as Arzan mentioned the other day, there are so many recipe websites and food websites available today in the Zoroastrian community. So we have a list of all those, and it's a real winner because food everybody goes after. Various galleries we have where a lot of audiovisual stuff is available. Like, we have a very good CD or a DVD presented by World Zoroastrian Cultural Foundation in terms of a lot of Zoroastrian cultural issues, like how to make a toran, or how to make a sadra, how to make a kasti. All those videos are available. And it's very, very fascinating. If you go to the gallery section, you'll find lots of these videos on culture, on religion. There are lots of videos where talks are being given by priests. We try to record them and put them in the gallery section. Cultural information, songs. Songs are really a hit. Monajats from various, Mani Rao is very famous. She has a variety of monajats she has sung. There are various other songs. Gathas are being sung by Iranians. Lots of material there on songs and videos, directories. Collective giving is another interesting area where people exchange. People who need something, they come and put up their needs, and people who want to give, they put up their offerings. And there is a lot of matchmaking taking place there. So when you are talking of a charity which wants to give, they want to finish a certain amount within a certain period. So they will come out and say, okay, we are offering this, this, this for a student or for a medical purpose. They are putting up that information, and people are applying online. The other option is a person who needs something. There are various instances when somebody is saying, I am so sick and I need help. We put up those cases, and charities from across the world, they are looking at those opportunities and they are giving. It's a very interesting area where we do an exchange of information on collective giving. Federations and associations, all the federations and associations across the world are listed here. So if you are going to a different city and you are wanting to connect with an association, you could be looking up their information online. We give their website so that you can connect to them directly. And of course, we have enough of resources on religion by scholars, by non-scholars, et cetera, et cetera. So we have a variety of things out here. I would like to share a couple of nice incidents which occurred. We had Zoroastrians and non-Zoroastrians from across the world who connect with us through the website. So we had one professor from Tenri University in Japan who was doing a study on intercultural studies. And he came up to our website and he did some research, got to us, came to India, went to TCS. He did a very interesting study on how TCS works based on the religion of the founders. And he presented a full paper. Unfortunately, that paper is in Japanese, so I could not appreciate the entire paper. But he gave me a brief summary, and it was very interesting. So even non-Zoroastrians come here, and they look up the resources. Because we must understand one thing, that we are slowly shrinking. So we have to create a resource base which is available to the world at large. And maybe this becomes something like an institution for posterity. We are recording something like what they used to record in caves. We now record on the internet so that it is there for posterity. So the website looks something like this. It's a very simple layout. If you want to subscribe, you just enter your email address down there on the right panel. You enter your email address, and from that day onwards, you will start getting the updates on the website automatically. You can get a weekly update, you can get a daily update, or you can get a post-by-post update. Whatever is updated on the website gets to you. The typical posts look something like this, and we have, as I was explaining to you, the categories on the left. So these are the categories under which information is filed. And on the main website, the posts are in chronological order. So as and when they appear, they are updated. On the left, you'd see that these are the topics that we are having. It's only part of the topics. It includes Agyaris, Atash Vairams, Avesta studies, books, businesses, education, Dungarwadi process. A lot of people asked for this when people die and they want to go back to India. What is the process that you need to follow? Even that is available right here. So what are the permissions you have to take in your home country? What are the permissions you have to take in India? What all things we need? Humor is a great, we have dramas and we have audio dramas which are recorded, which are available online. So if you want to listen to an old Adi Marzban drama, maybe you could try to look up there. A lot of interfaith activities which are being done by people within our religion, especially with the UN, et cetera, are being recorded here. And you can have access to it also. If you want to participate, you can connect with the people concerned and participate in that also. Nowruz and Nowjots and weddings and whatnot. It's a real treasure trove. You could get lost. If you dive into it, maybe it could take a couple of months to even assess what all information is there. Over a period of time, we have, as she mentioned, Dolly mentioned, we have got over 1 million hits on this site within the last 7 years. And for a small community like ours, it's really a big achievement. That is all about resources that we have. We also have another website called ZoroastrianDirectory.com. Now, what this does is it just lists the name and the contact details of the people across the world. So we have about 78,000 people, more than 78,000 people, who are available online. If you go to this website, you need to register once because you have to offer your own details. The registration process is very simple. You just have to enter your basic details. The site looks something like this. You have this option, new user register. Just click on this. You create your own login ID and password. Give your first name, last name, email ID. These are the compulsory things. The rest of the things are optional. And of course, your basic contact details. If you don't have an email ID, of course, if you're coming online, there's no question of not having an email ID. So you put your email ID. The rest of the things, your telephone numbers, birth date, address, etc., are all optional. But I would urge you to at least enter your profession because people can search you by profession also. So when you are entering your own data, try to put in the data which is going to be useful for people to connect to you. As in when somebody is looking for you, he should be able to find you. So the login screen is very simple. Very minimal information is required. And then when you go to search, you can search by any of these parameters. So you can search by profession, by city, by country, or if you know the first or last name, you can search by any two of these. So you can say, I know one Pardiwala in Navsari. And you could be looking up all the names of Pardiwalas in Navsari. Or as I have shown you here, suppose I am looking for an attorney in New York. Okay, you can just put the profession and the city. That is why you understand the importance of putting the profession for yourself also. So if somebody is looking for you, he may know your profession, he may not know your name. So if I want a tour operator in Delhi, I might just say tour and the city will be New Delhi. And you should be able to see the list of people who are available anywhere in the world. In fact, this has been used very, very effectively by people who are traveling. One of my friends was traveling to Sydney, and he says, I want to know the names of all the Parsis in Sydney. And maybe I can connect to a few of them. So what he did is we went here, he went, made a search, Sydney, and country was Australia, of course. And he got the list. He wrote to a few people randomly. He connected with a couple of people, and he got his contacts. And he started working from there onwards. Another interesting thing which is connected to this is we had one lady who was stuck in Hong Kong. And she had some difference between her visa spelling name of hers, the spelling was wrong, and her passport spelling was wrong. So one night at 8 o'clock, she wrote to me saying that, can you help me in Hong Kong? So I just looked up the directory, found some people in Hong Kong, gave her the contacts. I said, you phone up any of these people, maybe one of them will help. And you won't believe, next day morning, she got connected to somebody, to the consulate. She got her visa done. By evening, she was in Bombay. And it was really, really satisfying. You know, these incidents, there are lots of these incidents which occur, that you can use this resource that we have for various things. You could be looking for a teacher in New York, or you could be looking for a tour operator, as I said, in Bombay. It is a very, very valuable resource. It happens immediately. Like if you're searching for an attorney in New York, you can see that you get three people. You click on the first name of any of these, and you get full contact details. So you could contact them by email, by telephone, by whatever method you want to. So you could be looking up their details. After the Parsi directory, what people were looking also was the institutions within the community. So there are lots of nonprofit institutions which are available in the community. And there is no single resource which aggregates all those resources. So this is the place where we have all the institutions within the community in one place. So in the process, we learned that there is a Zoroastrian hostel in Tehran, which I never knew. So if you, again, the search is the same way, by name, by location, and by category. So if you're looking for something in Bombay, for example, you want to book a bag for a wedding or a Navjot, you don't have the information immediately. What you do is you go to the Parsi institutions. There is no login required here because it is open for all. You can just go there, do a search. The categories are all listed. You have Anjumans, Atash Bairams, hospitals, dispensaries, dharamshalas, foundations, orphanages, Parsi press, All of it is there. You just look it up by category. You look up the city or country, and you will get the information immediately. So here I have given you an example. I'm looking for an agyari in Navsari, and I've seen there are so many agyaris in Navsari. You could just click on the first name and get the details, address. Many agyaris don't have an email address, but at least they have a local address which you can write to, or maybe they have a telephone number which you can call them on. So this also is a very, very useful resource when you are looking up institutions across the world. Like if you are looking for an association in New York, maybe there are two associations in New York. You can see the list of both the associations. You may write to any of them, and that will be your contact with the institution anywhere in the world. And then we have the missing Parsi. If you know of a friend, if you know of someone who's long lost and you would like to find that person, this is available for both Parsis as well as non-Parsis. So we have cases where people say, I knew of somebody called Gandevia in 1975. I had met him in Bombay and he was in so-and-so school and his sister was studying in so-and-so school. She was married and probably now her last name is so-and-so. You write a full detailed account. People visit this site and they come back with answers. They say, oh, he is my neighbor, or oh, I have last seen him here and he was dead at that time, but then his wife is still living. It's a very, very valuable resource for finding people who are not listed on the directory. So the first thing is you go to the directory. If you find him there, fine. If you don't find him there, you can put up your query here and people can get connected. Both the Missing Parsi and Zoroastrians.net, we have been able to connect people. Like we had one guy, one very senior lawyer in Bombay, he called me up and he says, oh, you are doing this. I want to find a person named so-and-so who has some huge land in Daman worth about 100 crores. And if he has any heirs, I would like to know, because somebody is trying to sell off that land as his own. And we want to trace that person. I put up that information on Zoroastrians.net. It got circulated. Within 24 hours, we found the heir. And I connected him with that lawyer. And now they are working on it to get the land back. You know, he said, I don't even know that he was found in Secunderabad. He said, I didn't even know that this land existed. My dad never told me that he had land in Daman. And then we connected him with him. And it was a really great experience. Of course, initially, you know how Parsis are. They were, why do you want to know, and who gave you my address, and how did you come to know, and stuff like that. But once I told him the story, and he says, what is your interest in this? And I said, nothing, I just want to connect you with the right person. Then it sunk into him, and then he connected with the lawyer, and he's now working on the papers to show that he is the real owner of that place. And now he is going to have a windfall. So there are many, many success stories like this. When we are connecting people, these are all the satisfaction that you get from connecting people out of the blue. Like he had no clue that something like this existed. And then when you get connected like this, it's a great feeling. So the Missing Parsi, we have solved almost 50% of the cases. So when people come and put up stuff, other people are also reading it. When somebody reads something, if you want to subscribe here again, you have a email subscription, you just put your email ID. Whenever a case is put up, you get that information in your mailbox and you can directly write back. Or you can look around, somebody will say, okay, my neighbor knows somebody, et cetera, et cetera. So it's a really great feeling to connect people across the world. And this is the latest project where we are looking at creating a huge family tree for all the Zoroastrians across the world. You know, everybody has their own family trees in their own small way, sometimes manually, sometimes typewritten, and they have their own trees. I came to know of one family, the Dada Chanjis, who have an entire book made out of their family tree. It's about 300 years family they have. And the earlier parts, before 1920, it's all in Gujarati. And after 1920, it's all in English in Excel format. And it's a really fascinating exercise that they have done. But everyone has these own pockets of information to themselves. The idea here is that ultimately each one of us will be connected to each other. And how we do it, we will just show it to you, how you can create your own family tree. It's a very simple process. You create yourself, your spouse, your children, your parents, your grandparents. Automatically it starts increasing. And then when somebody else comes in, we connect them to each other. Suppose you are ultimately related to somebody who is your brother. He has entered it separately. We connect them, and ultimately we expect, I don't know whether it will happen in my lifetime or not, but we expect the entire community to be connected one day. So this is a very unique site which connects all Parsis, Iranis across the world. We use a lot of social media in this, where we use the Facebook as a login. Incidentally, in India, we also have an Uthamna service. You know, the typical old days, like everybody used to wake up and read the Jame and look for the Paidas. But Paidas is too late in the day when we send these SMSs. We have a free SMS service in India. So if you subscribe to that service by just dialing this, give a missed call to this number, you subscribe to the service, next day onwards, the Uthamnas for the day are coming to you by SMS. Okay, so people have that opportunity, and we are doing it all India. So now people in Surat are sending that information, Pune, they are sending the information, Nagpur is sending the information, Bombay, of course, we have the information directly. And this is very, very well accepted. Old people especially are very fascinated by this.
They have SMS.
SMS, cell phone now is a given thing. They may not have internet, but at least a cell phone they have. So they are really fascinated, and if 2 days nobody dies, I get calls. What is happening? Why am I not getting the SMS? They are getting addicted to it. I said, but nobody is dead. If nobody dies, what can I do? So people get addicted to it. They wait for the SMS in the morning, like between 8 and 9, we send the SMS, and people do get back to me. So it's very fascinating. Also on this, we have a Android and iPhone app called CommuTree. You can download that app, install it on your phone. CommuTree is an app which does family trees. Now they do it for many, many communities. We have signed up to say, you please carry Parsi community also. Now this is available internationally. So if you have an Android phone or if you have an iPhone, you can just download this app, select your community as Parsi one time, and from then on, you'll start getting news from the Parsi community on a daily basis, right on your cell phone. So if you have a smartphone and you install that app, it's a very good app, and daily, whatever is posted on Zoroastrians.net keeps coming to you. Plus, all the features that are there, which we shall see now in the Parsi family, also will come to you automatically. CommuTree. CommuTree. Yeah, go to the App Store and look for CommuTree. You can download the app. In the settings, one time you select Parsi because there are many other communities there. So you just select Parsi once, and then onwards, all the Parsi news you start getting on a day-to-day basis, right on your cell phone. It could be news, it could be various resources which are put up on Zoroastrians.net. You could look for a summary also, so you can only get a summary. If you want to unsubscribe, you can unsubscribe anytime. So you don't need to. No, not at the moment. Not at the moment. But there are a couple of ads which pop up, which might be a little irritating, but then we have to carry the ads because we are doing this free for the community. So the entire thing is free. The ads are paying for it. So you might have to put up with some ads here and there. But otherwise, you get some information, install it and see. If you like it, keep it. If you don't like it, you can always uninstall. There's nothing hard and fast about it. You can jump in anytime. Right.
My kids look at that word, they're going to shut it off.
It is. Okay. We can talk about friends. We can talk about relationships. You can talk about connections. Yeah. Right. Quickly, I'll round up. And then we can have questions. So the Parsi family website looks something like this, where you can create your own family tree, just like in a tree format. You have the parents, and you have the kids, and you have the kids below that. And it can go on and on. There is no limit to this. It can be 20 levels down and 40 levels across. There is absolutely no limit to the entire thing. I'll quickly show you how this is done. What you do is, one time you log in, either through your Facebook account or with your Gmail account. Or in India just now, we have a new feature where you can SMS a particular number and you can get a PIN. Because we need to identify that we don't get junk. The idea is that if you have a Facebook account, then at least you are identified. We can trace who it is. So this is the way in which you connect first time. You fill in a simple form. Again, now, details on the form are only for information of verifying what you are and who you are. The details are not going to be universally advertised. Only your name and your relationship is what is critical. These are the only two things which you can, which will be given to the public. All your other details, your date of birth and your cell phone number, etc., is not universally given. It is just held on the website so that in case there is a problem, we should be able to track who that person is. Once you enter your details, you enter your basic details, like your mom and dad, your children, and you create a simple tree like this. This is my family tree, my parents, myself, my wife, my sister, my kids, and my sister's kids, etc., etc. So you can go any level down, like you can say more or less, and you can go on progressing down below. You go on adding siblings, you go on adding spouses, multiple spouses, divorce, everything is available. You can go on and on, and it can become a really huge family tree. Like as I said, like Dada Chanji's, they have a full book, and we converted their entire book into this digital form. And it's a really huge tree. Like they have some 3,000-4,000 people within their tree itself. During the process of developing this, we got a family tree of the Wadias, the shipbuilders, original shipbuilders. And they have a huge family tree, and they have it all in a huge sheet. It cannot be even printed, but they have done it manually. And about 200 years of data they have in terms of who was born when did he die, etc., etc. We are planning to do a huge family tree for the Udoda Darsujis also. They have something, but it is in Gujarati, number one. Number two is they don't have the females. They only have the male progeny because they want to track who is the descendant and who is authorized to be there. We are trying to get the females also because then the tree has to be complete. These are some of the challenges that we face, but it is really a very fascinating tool. And once you are on it, you can connect with people. You can just do a search here on top, and you can say, I want to search for so-and-so, and maybe you are connected to him, your entire relationship will be displayed to you immediately. It's really fascinating. Once you create your listing, then automatically your occupation is tracked. So how many people we have as accountants, lawyers, computer consultants, marketing professionals, etc., etc., all this is available immediately. Again, the stats part shows us the total population by village or native place, that is the origin and the current place, where you are originally born and what is your current place of residence. This is very powerful in terms of if you are looking for somebody in a certain area, you can even look it up from here. And of course, we have a whole lot of things, like if you want to put up your academic results or upcoming events for an organization or for an association, you can come and put it up here. Encourage people to come and connect to each other here. You can create your own groups. It's like a mini Facebook for Zoroastrians. Everything is taken care of. One more thing I wanted to show you is find your life partner. Again, matrimonial, what you call it is going to be a challenge. But we have a find your life partner here. We have various Parsi publications, Zoroastrian publications here. Past issues of Fezana Journal, Parsi Times, Fezana Bulletin. Now we have Zagni also. We keep on updating this. So all the Parsi publications you'll get in one place. And you can look up any past issue anytime. These are all documented and chronologically organized. So if you go and click see old publications, you'll see all of them with all the past issues. The last three issues are here, and the old issues are all available. So if you want to see a Parsi Times of, say, 2 years ago, you should be able to click here and find it.
Is the entire thing on it?
Oh, yes.
The entire journal?
Yes, yes. The entire Fezana journal is there. Yeah, Fezana is putting it up on their website. Fezana journal is on their own website. Here, what we are doing is we are aggregating all the Parsi publications from across the world. We are aggregating and trying to put. Some people are easy to break. Some people don't want to give it. So it takes a little time. But ultimately, it's not a question of whether. It's a question of when. They'll ultimately fall in line because everybody wants to be publicized. So we have all the publications out here. Search your life partner. What do you call it? Matrimonial or life partner. This is also available on the app. So if you go on the app and look up, you say age between so-and-so through so-and-so, gender so-and-so, with photo, without photo, you do a search. You get a list of people. You can see their background, their families. If you're interested, you can write directly to them. We don't do any physical matchmaking, but at least we have the means to meet. See, nobody should say that I don't have the means. Whether it is learning religion, whether to find a partner, whether to get any resource, the idea behind all this is you get everything under one roof, and nobody should say, oh, I didn't know. Whether it's prayers, Navjot prayers, whatever you want, they are all there. And of course, we talked about this, having a Uthamna online and the app. All the above websites are free to use, non-controversial, not aligned to anyone. So there is no issue in terms of loyalties and fights and controversies. These are all independent. They are all managed by me. They are available for the global community for free. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer.
Thank
you very much.
Thanks
a lot.
Thank you.
If you have any questions, yeah, we can. Yes, please.
I have a quick question about the family tree. Do you have a plan to tell you if somebody is alive?
You have to enter it yourself. If you enter it, the person can be listed on the family tree even if he's dead. You can say that this person died on so and so date. In fact, on the main screen, we have something called Shraddhanjali. Like if you want to pay your respects or you want to condole somebody, you can even condole somebody because that name and the picture is available. But I would urge you all to put your pictures also on the family tree because then it's very easy to recognize people across the world.
Is there any DNA tracking?
No, not yet. We have this blood group tracking, but not the DNA tracking, no. You can print out your own family tree, but there are challenges if it is really wide. Then it becomes an issue. Then it'll come very, very tiny, and you won't be able to see it. But yes, the function is there. The printout function is there. Yes.
Yeah, I had a question. Do you have a copy of these slides?
Yes, I can give them to you. In fact, I'll give you, I'm sorry. You can just carry this with you. all these, you can just take one and pass. All these sites are listed here. Yes?
Attempt to connect the WZCC information, so we had provided information on professions and stuff in there.
Right.
Is that linked to
the? Yes, okay. It is linked.
Thank you.
WZCC information is linked with the profession and the location. Yes.
Okay, thank you very much for coming. I mean, the next speaker is right here. And, not take away from the
thank you very much.